And okay, we're going into the game in the top right. It's the blue Protoss player, actually surprisingly down a game. It is Indy. And in the bottom left, the red Zerg player. It is the co-op man himself, Loco.
Maybe we should do a show match between the two players slash commentators of this tournament. What do you think about that, if you did a show match against Halston?
Sure, I'd be up for that.
I'll ask him what he thinks. I think that'd be fun. Because both of you were casting equally, yeah. Actually, 3 days and 3 days. So I think that'd be fun. Like maybe like $400 or something.
Sure, I'm definitely done.
Try and make it happen. I think it would be more fun than... Actually, to be honest, it would be fun as well to do something like Hearthstone against the winner of the tournament, but... At the same time, you know, it's like a pro against a caster, so even though the caster is supposed to be pretty good.
We could do the two finalists playing Archon against Hearthstone. Or something like that.
That's pretty sick. Yeah, I'm going to think about it, see like what I can come up with, maybe try to organize some extra stuff. But actually, one of the important things is that we'll have a third place match. There's a prize pool differential between third and fourth. So, and also, because the top four is offline, I didn't want people to travel, play one match, and then be done if they lose, right? So, whoever loses in their semifinals, they still got the third place match to look forward to. And remember, guys, today, at the end of this group, I'll announce the round of 8 matchups, which will all take place tomorrow. And then next month, at the end of the month, is when the offline finals will take place over in Italy, with all everybody traveling there, the casters. Sadly, I couldn't get you there, Lambo, but maybe next time.
I already saw the house anyways. I was there for the Clash Invitational, the pro gamer one, and it was very fun there too.
How long did you stay there?
We had also, I think, like the tournament was 2 days, and I arrived the day before, and I left the day after, so I was at the house for 4 days, which was really nice. We played a lot of ping pong there.
Nice. Are you good?
I'm decent, I would say. But there's a couple of, a manager of Clash that is really good in ping pong.
Yeah.
Red is also very good.
Oh, okay. I used to think I was good at ping pong, and then I moved to China, and I lost to, I'm not joking you, everyone. Literally everyone. I never won a match there against the Chinese. And I was like, okay, yeah, no, I was not good. I guess people in France are terrible, because I was like actually decent in the club I played in when I was in school.
Oh, you even played in a club? Yeah, then you're probably way better than me.
I thought I was, but not really.
Oh, 2 adapts trading into the main. Cancel though. But again, forcing 10 Zerglings. And Indy just going for the Oracle first again. I have the feeling this game maybe he can go for an Icon Drop follow-up, possibly.
Yeah.
That's kind of the mind game you do as a Protoss, because both of the build orders look exactly the same. And they start exactly the same. And Zerg can't really scout it.
If you see one Adept, or you got a very good feeling that it's going to be 2 Adepts coming your way, what's the best way to deal with it? How many links do you get?
So there's a. I do this very specifically. If there are 2 adepts are coming across the map, they have to be 2 chrono boosts. So I wait. I see this. I wait to see if there's a second chrono boost or not. And if there's a second chrono boost, I see this right before my natural queen pops, and I go creep tumor first, my natural. And then I make a third queen in the main base, go to my natural with the queen in the main, start a third queen in my main, and then I make 8 links. And then usually because of the creep at the natural, I can pressure the adepts and force them to back off while following the shade. So that's, I think, how you should defend the 2 adepts.
Yeah. You should make tutorials about this. I feel like that could help a lot of players.
Yeah, I'm kind of just streaming and then hoping that if people have trouble with this kind of stuff, they just ask in chat.
Yeah, but like this is the kind of stuff, like if you make a tutorial about it one time and like you call it how to deal with the first 2 adepts or whatever, like make a very short video, you post it, you can do a comment in your chat, and then it's just gonna spam the video over and over, and like everybody's gonna see it, and it's gonna help a lot of people in the lower league a lot, I think.
Yeah, maybe. I did something similar with how to inject.
Yeah.
Also, just as a comment.
But like you made a video or?
Yeah, on YouTube.
Okay. All right, guys, check out Clash Lambo's YouTube. It's got
Yeah,
some good
Lambo
videos.
SA too.
Damn, that probe almost getting caught. Nice mineral walk actually here going through the adepts.
Yeah, really nice micro. And as I said, Indy is going for the mind game. So far, Loco didn't scout anything. So for all he knew, just now he saw the warp prism actually. For all he knew so far, it could have still been two Stargate Phoenix.
Loco's trying to bust into that natural wall while attacking, seizing that third base.
Oh. And he's getting some decent trades here with the Zerglings. This is mainly due to Indy being a bit greedy with the Oracle. Usually the Oracle is supposed to be at home with the third Nexus. And yeah, those links are actually doing quite a bit of damage. And now if he just waits until the Oracle deactivates the beam, he can go in again.
Oh, that prism across the map. Morphing some Archons that are gonna go forward now for Mindy. Stepping on creep, there is a queen there already in position. Charge just finished.
Yeah, he actually went for 6 gate, so this, I think he's gonna work in 6 charge shots on the other side.
This is very dangerous. Loco on the other side trying to deal with that expansion. Oracle being activated once more. Shield battery helping. Oh, Loco, you're attacking your own archery! Stop it!
These casters, man, they just attack the buildings all the time. No, I think in this game, Loco actually, he spotted the warp prism that he didn't realize that there was a warp prism there. And yeah, I think now he's just dead. Like, the 6 gate charge shot Archon is very good against the strategy that Loco went for, which is a quick plus 1 melee. And then a Ling Bane based defense. You can defend it, but you need a lot of queens, which Loco didn't have. So Indy just caught him off guard a bit there.
It looked a little bit dangerous for a second, but Indy didn't take, you know, nearly enough damage. Their links didn't breach the natural, and then now the counter attack. Just not quite ready for it here. Loco needs more units. He starts on losing queens, so he can't even inject anymore. And a lot of his hatcheries. The third hatch is down, and yeah, he's taking more and more damage here. Mornings are going to be forced, and Indy gets the equalizer.